The Complete Works of Swami Vivekananda. Mission of the Vedanta. An address delivered by Swamiji to the residents of Kumbakonam in 1897, Part 1. A very small amount of religious work performed brings a large amount of result. If this statement of the Gita wanted an illustration, I am finding every day the truth of that great saying in my humble life. My work has been very insignificant indeed, but the kindness and the cordiality of welcome that have met me at every step of my journey from Colombo to this city are simply beyond all expectations. Yet at the same time, it is worthy of our traditions as Hindus. It is worthy of our race, for here we are, the Hindus race, whose vitality, whose life principles, whose very soul, as it were, is in religion. I have seen a little of the world, travelling among the races of the East and the West, and everywhere I find among nations one great ideal which forms the backbone, so to speak, of that race. With some it is politics, with others it is social culture. Others again may have the intellectual culture and so on for their national background. But this, our motherland, has religion, and religion alone for its basis, for its backbone, for the bedrock upon which the whole building of its life has been based. Some of you may remember that in my reply to the kind address which the people of Madras sent over to me in America, I pointed out the fact that a peasant in India has in many respects a better religious education than many a gentleman in the West. And today, beyond all doubt, I myself am verifying my own words. There was a time when I did feel rather discontented at the want of information among the masses of India and the lack of thirst among them for information. But now I understand it. Where their interest lies, they are more eager for information than the masses of any other race that I have seen or have travelled along. Ask our peasants about the monumentous political changes in Europe, the upheavals that are going on there in European society. They do not know anything of them, nor do they care to know. But the peasants, even in Ceylon, detached from India in many ways, cut off from a living interest in India, I found those very peasants working in the fields were already acquainted with the fact that there had been a parliament of religions in America, that an Indian sannyasi had gone over there, and that he had had some success. Where therefore their interest is, they are as eager for information as any other race. And religion is one and the sole interest of the people of India. I am not just now discussing whether it is good to have the vitality of the race in religious ideals or in political ideals, but so far as it is clear to us that for good or for evil, our vitality is concentrated in our religion. You cannot change it, you cannot destroy it and put it in place of another. You cannot transplant a large growing tree from one soil to another and make it immediately take root there. For good or for evil, the religious ideal that has been flowing into India for thousands of years, for good or for evil, the Indian atmosphere that has been filled with ideals of religion for shining scores of centuries, for good or for evil, we have been born and brought up in the very midst of these ideals or ideas of religion till it has entered into our very blood and tingled with every drop in our veins and has become one with our constitution, become the very vitality of our lives. Can you give such religion up without rousing of the same energy in reaction? Without filling the channel which that mighty river has cut out for itself in the course of thousands of years? Do you want that the Ganga should go back to its icy bed and begin a new course? Even if that were possible, it would be impossible for this country to give up her characteristic course of religious life and take up for herself a new career of politics or something else. You can work only under the law of least resistance. And this religious line is the line of least resistance in India. This is the line of life. This is the line of growth. And this is the line of well-being in India, to follow the track of religion.